Dear David and dear members of our international team, our large Christian family. The year of 2021 was the year of tests. It was full of challenges, limitations, threats to our rights to get together and even organize Christian events. Regardless, there is a lot we have been able to achieve in Ukraine. In 2021, we held the largest interdenominational Christian event, which became not only the largest in Ukraine, but in all of Europe. That is when over 8,000 people prayed together downtown Kyiv during the National Prayer for Ukraine. I could go on listing the achievements of David Hathaway ministry in Ukraine, but instead, we met with almost all the leaders of the largest Christian denominations and church unions of our country. Let us hear the thoughts, standpoints, and evaluation personally from them of all the work that has been done with David Hathaway's ministry in Ukraine. So, here goes. I'd begin by speaking about David rather than about Ukrainians first. I believe he's an outstanding man of God, and God led him to Ukraine. He combines various qualities. He is very close with God, he hears God, and he senses that God expects from him. He has no lack of resources, both in spiritual and material sense. I believe David Hathaway began bringing Bibles into Ukraine even before Billy Graham did. He wasn't as well known at that point, and he didn't go advertising this publicly, but he started bringing them in before him. We've discussed the post-Soviet era, but he started way before. He did it during that period, which was quite hard. There are actual church unions which had just begun their existence back in those times. Back in the times, and people like David Hathaway really contributed to those new churches being established. The pastors, the leaders were all inexperienced, and they needed sort of like an older brother who had a good grasp of things, and at that point there wasn't even enough unity to be able to turn to anyone. So many of those inexperienced pastors looked up to people like David Hathaway and learned from their experience and everything he had to go through, and that somewhat strengthened them in a certain way. It's the contribution he made to the unity among churches through organizing and having the National Day of Prayer for Ukraine. That was a really huge contribution. Well, the reality was that up until 2015, there had really been no events where Baptists, Pentecostals, Adventists, and Charismatics, and Messianic Jews, etc., would all be getting on the same platform, speaking from the same stage, so diverse, yet praying together. Now, regarding the large events that you've mentioned, if they do contribute to unity among churches and among all these different, say, Christian denominations, that is a great call to Christians, a call to get united around the same goals, around what is common between us, disregarding what makes us different doctrinally. That is what I believe. I believe David's ministry contributes a lot to this. Well, unity is what Jesus was actually praying about, his archpriest prayer, the last prayer he said, let them be one. Although these days I can attest to that, within the National Day of Prayer and within David Hathaway's ministry, we have walked a certain path, and we now see the reality of what we're doing. And this reality is not just political, it is actual, it's rather tangible, and it yields results. Certainly, I'd heard a lot about David, lots of good things, And I remember hearing about him from back in the 90s as he was starting his ministry in Ukraine. And people always referred to him in a positive way only. What he has done now, though, is sort of a milestone in his life, I guess. He managed to unite a huge number of churches and believers and bring them all together and have them all unite in prayer, for the purpose of prayer. I know that David Hathaway has been working in Ukraine, and he gave Ukraine a lot for a long time, but what he was doing with individual churches or even unions or small denominations still could not amount to this kind of success. So as we met back in 2015, both from him and from us, the suggestions were to publicize it and make it more known to everyone, to build it on a larger scale so that all the churches would be included. Holding events together has become somewhat of a trend among us. It has become popular and even necessary for the churches and the heads of denominations and for all people in general. I believe that this National Day of Prayer has done its service in various areas, more than one. It has laid what I believe is a foundation for an absolute new religious unity in Ukraine. The work that has been done in Ukraine, even in the past 5 years, is a blessing and a joy. It's exciting. It's inspiring for thousands and thousands of people who either come to this day of prayer in person or whoever watches it on TV, online, and radio broadcasting, and they're also able to share this joy. This work is commendable. It is to be regarded as a great blessing. This project is rather unique. It's a unique platform and opportunity that emerged in Ukraine for activities like these. It'll be a blessing for all of us if this takes place further on. It helps us understand each other better, helps us trust one another, helps us not to be afraid of each other and get over certain barriers that come up in this aspect. Certainly, we can see how God is blessing us in this. We also have numerous testimonies of healing connected to David Hathaway's ministry. People came with different problems and troubles after that, sometime after the event, after some time, and after the service, they would testify that they'd received some kind of healing or deliverance from certain problems. So there is actual fruit, saved souls, healed and delivered. David seems to have chosen to focus on the East while the East was still hostile towards him. Even so, that didn't stop him. He didn't stop coming here even after imprisonment. At this point, his ministry was able to gain even more momentum, and as once he was accused for smuggling the Bibles into Ukraine, he is now doing this openly and freely in Eastern Ukraine. And it's welcome, it's totally acceptable. And the people who didn't have an easy access to the Bible or hold it in their hands now have the Word of God come closer to them, even to their homes. From a Christian standpoint, we can't stress this enough. It's not even a question. David Hathaway has done an incredibly important work as he spread the Word of God so widely. I believe a great reward is expecting him in the kingdom of God, because this is the most important thing there is in the world. The most important thing God gave people. It was the Bible, His Word. Since it's not only the National Day of Prayer, but you're also having a wide range of other activities that are centered around the Word of God and where hope is brought to those who may have lost it, my evaluation is nothing but positive. The level of consistency and commitment David has shown over the years calls for deep respect and trust. We are grateful for the whole team built by David Hathaway. The office is doing a great job. They seem to be able to create the right atmosphere, which is great. Everyone taking part feels comfortable, and we really appreciate that. I'd like to say a big thank you to David Hathaway and your whole team, in the first place, for the initiative you've taken, secondly, for the provision, which made it all possible, and finally, for you managing to somehow bring together different denominations, so diverse in character, in mentality, in ministry style. You were able to create the format that fit all those denominations in at once. This isn't just an office that was opened in Kiev. I believe it's somewhat of a new page that is very important for Ukraine and Ukrainian Christianity in particular, as well as Ukrainian reality and life of our society. These important things that have been sown, I believe, are yet to bring fruit for the new generation of Christians here in Ukraine. It was very important for the prayer movement to sweep across Ukraine, every town, every village, every region, every oblast. We need the work everywhere. That is what we call a movement, not just an event. I want it to be a great prayer movement. That is something we really want to have. I'd say making attempts to organize similar events on a regional scale, in western, southern, eastern Ukraine. In the regional context, this could be an interesting development aspect for prayer. You see, not everyone can make it to Kiev, but in regions people could come together easier. Well, besides our events that are related to prayer, I'd get to planning evangelism outreach. We have a certain level of relationship built right now that we can be thinking of a different format of involving our brother David Hathaway and having different events. We're thinking about it, we're praying about it, and Lord willing, we'll go through with it. I believe it would be really great if we continued using larger venues. We've been using the National Palace of Sports for the National Day of Prayer. It would be good to use the stadium, for instance, to invite people to accept Jesus Christ and follow Christ. I think that is possible, especially in Ukraine. It would be possible. It can happen. It's real. Provided that prayerful preparation is done well. If it's all well organized, with the organization that is submitted to the Lord. And another aspect is to have the people on the stage that the Lord has prepared a great harvest through. Now this would be really, really serious. And the fruit from it would be the one that lasts. I believe that a project like this is possible, but the preparation has to be quite serious. We all need to join in, the whole Ukraine, together. And with this kind of enthusiasm, it is possible. It is something we could work on. This would be yet another manifestation of our unity and the declaration of the church being alive and taking responsibility, that it has not disappeared. We'd remind people that the church is still there. Movements like these contribute to unity. Society understands that something big is happening right there. David has tremendous experience, a lot of knowledge, a lot of all of it. And I would suggest that all over Ukraine, he would develop either centers or smaller points representing David Hathaway's ministry. All this with the purpose of passing on experience in outreach and prayer. For instance, if we not only organize the National Day of Prayer, but also regional or oblast days of prayer in Kherson, Odessa, Nikolaev Oblast, per se, all throughout the year, and then we get all these people together again in June, which perhaps would be more expensive, but not necessarily on a larger scale, it is really helpful when people in the regions have already experienced their own day of prayer, and then these very people are involved in the National Day of Prayer. That brings many things to life. An outreach on a larger scale, definitely. I believe if it did take place, its significance, I think, could be equal or perhaps even bigger as compared to the National Day of Prayer for Ukraine. And surely other means of evangelism as well. They should be involved in cooperation with other churches, obviously. Why not? After all, we have all come together on this particular platform. Baptists, Pentecostals, Adventists, Charismatics, Messianic Jews. There are platforms like these in oblasts, in the regions, that we can actually use when discussing and planning similar events. While all of the denominations are currently united in prayer, we don't quite see the same thing in evangelism. Even so, we know that people only get saved through the gospel. Christ in his life here on earth had two major ministries. One was preaching of the gospel, and the other was discipleship. So it's truly important to follow in his footsteps, since we're disciples of Christ, of course, and do the same thing in unity as well. I will also be praying that the National Day of Evangelism would also take place in Ukraine. If we only do evangelism without prayer, there will be no success, just as there will be none if we only pray and don't evangelize. These two things have to work together at all times. It is both possible and important, in my personal opinion. I think we can already start thinking about ways to use the prayer platform for the outreach now, so that it is also evangelistic. It may be a bit harder to achieve because of different denominations and them believing different things. Either way, my opinion is that where there is a lot of prayer, there has to be a lot of evangelism. Surely, with mass public outreach, there has to be internet outreach, personal witnessing, evangelism in all areas of life, face-to-face, etc. But I believe that mass public evangelism events will never be out the door. Frankly speaking, that has been my dream for many years. I've dreamt about this for over 30 years now. It's like it's been chasing me. They have built all these stadiums, even the new ones. Our Central Olympic Stadium has recently been reconstructed, and there has been no large-scale evangelistic event at it yet. May God help David Hathaway initiate something like this. I personally would support this. I'm ready. I don't think I am the only one, though. Let us have a powerful evangelism event with testimonies, broadcasting and everything, so this would give glory to Jesus Christ. If we do an optimistic calculation of all the Protestant churches in Ukraine, that would be just about 500,000 people. Now, 500,000 people can easily fill any stadium. It's more of a question of desire and organization. There just has to be someone who has the vision for large events like these. Prayer connecting with evangelism results, that is an explosion. That has an explosive effect. So we are not just dreaming, but we're praying this would come to pass. Public outreach leads to revival within the church. The gifts are being revived and developed. People are coming out on the streets and witnessing, and that is something they don't normally do unless there is an event, in most cases. An unbeliever would feel more comfortable attending a neutral venue than a church right away. So this leads to spiritual changes and impact. In some countries, in fact, this dynamic works even better than any other method. Naturally, there is time for everything. I do believe that what we had in the 90s is quite unlikely to repeat again, at least in the nearest future. That was a special time and era. But God has His own special ways. He can work it so public evangelism becomes relevant. In fact, the past years have actually shown that. Lots of people since 2014 and 15 facing fierce troubles, tears, uncertainty, and even death were very open to God, open in a special way. My belief is that besides mass evangelism, public evangelism with a lot of believers and ministers, David could also seriously influence and impact individual communities, specific congregations. He could strengthen them, strengthen the leaders and evangelists in all these communities. He could share his experience and, what is especially important, his anointing. I deeply believe in passing on of the anointing. It's very biblical. And when it's all over and done, perhaps a conference could be organized either in Britain or here in Ukraine. And the ministers of Jewish communities could come together, and through them, through them, David could have deeper and greater impact going further, having our Messiah's body grow. What he is doing is very large and powerful, and I wish he was not only understood and blessed here in Ukraine, but also in England. So there would be some sort of feedback, and this blessing would be passed on from Ukraine. We don't just want to receive from England in the person of David Hathaway in either aspect. My wish is for it all to be reciprocal, and because Ukraine is grateful. Perhaps we could express our gratitude by praying for Britain. The National Day of Prayer, one desire there was is to bring all denominations together and have them join in prayer. Was it achieved? Undoubtedly. I give it a high grade on his side because that is based on the initial vision of the event. Taking into account that David had quite an unpleasant experience in Ukraine and he still came back and became the catalyst for the National Day of Prayer, that is very valuable. Not everyone could do that. God bless David in his ministry to Ukraine. I believe that he has truly entered the history of Christianity in Ukraine as the person who initiated not only the National Day of Prayer, but a person who also spread the gospel and brought Christians together. There's a lot of good fruit that we already see in Ukraine, and I believe we'll see even more. David Hathaway, without exaggeration, I can say he put an end to 100 years of misunderstandings among the churches here. A century of division. We didn't just get closer, though. Through his ministry, we started preaching at each other's churches. We worship and sing and we pray together. That is without exaggeration. As for prayer results, I believe we'll soon see the reality of it. there will be peace in Ukraine. This unity that we have discussed, he has been achieving it step by step through consistency, through tolerance and respect, as well as personal contact with many of the leaders. Now, this is, as they say, top-notch. It's what they call spiritual art. Praise God he led David here, and he was able to find a key to every leader. And our churches are on fire now. In fact, we now expect, we anticipate the time when we get together again, to meet again. Surely, in the first place, it's preaching heart to heart and large outreach. But I guess the more important aspect is the question of influence. Influence on people's mentality, influence on the next generation. The issue is understanding. Understanding of its importance and directing youth and our next generations so that they could learn, so that they could grow in all this kind of activity. I don't deny the effectiveness of large-scale events. I wouldn't exclude those. But perhaps after the pandemic is over, we'll fill a couple of stadiums. We're ready to cooperate in various directions for the good of Ukraine and Great Britain. And our brother David Hathaway is a bridge between them. We're sincerely grateful to him. We will continue praying that he remains in the spirit, in good shape, and in good health, always smiling, and he is welcome in Ukraine. You have just seen and heard personal experience of bishops and heads of Christian denominations in Ukraine regarding cooperation and serving together with David Hathaway's ministry and our team. And I'll dare say your team, since we are an integral part of the large international ministry. As you can see, Ukraine has a unique support and unprecedented platform for holding the biggest, most effective and large-scale Christian events. You will surely make objective conclusions on your own. One way or another, this kind of support is a deposit in spreading David's vision not only across Ukraine. As a matter of fact, this should set the precedent and the example for other countries how through the unity between the churches, the government, and the people of Ukraine, evangelism and prayer can be organized on a national scale. Witnessing can be done on a large level unseen before, with us sharing the gospel and spreading his word.